Yes, my dear, very good morning to all of you. Now, I came here with my English class. I am Shivaji Tripathi and have much more experience of English teaching. And right now I have got an opportunity to teach you people. As far as my experience is concerned, I have been appointed as head examiner for ISC, ICSC and AISSC and AISSCE. It means CBSC and ICSC both. That is, continuously without any interruption I have got 20 years experience of English teaching. It is not sufficient. Why? Because unless or until you understand me and I can modulate my voice to you people, that is sufficient. Now today, as you are now in intermediate, that is 11th class, so I would like to begin 11th class chapter, the first chapter, Hornbill, the portrait of a lady. Actually, the portrait, let us see what is portrait. Portrait is a photograph or a figure or a picture that generally we hang over the wall. That someone's figure, someone's portrait, especially we keep the portrait live and dead personalities. You would have seen, have been hanged along with the garland. And generally the little child, whenever see the portrait, might raise the question, who this person is. Now, Khushwant Singh, as you know, that he was born on February 2nd, 1915 at Hadali, Pakistan, before the partition. Now, and he was died in Sujan Park, Delhi, Sujan Singh Park, Delhi, on March 20, 2014. Recently he has been died. Actually, he was very much influenced with the partition of India in 1947. And the experience of this partition has given him idea to write Train to Pakistan. In 1956, he has written, that have become much more popular novel, and he became famous for this. Actually, in this chapter, the portrait of a lady, we do not see the portrait. We see the portrait of his grandfather. We do not see the portrait of grandmother. Actually, we see the portrait, that is the life figure of his grandmother. His grandfather was no more. And he has, from his little age up to the youth, he has just studied, he had seen his grandmother, and he find how his grandmother was. And he has described about his grandmother's nature, the way of living, how she was controlling the house, how was she interfering. Actually, this is the inner idea of the grandparents, that they want to take care of their grandchildren. Here, as for the summary of this chapter, Khushwant Singh has been observing his grandmother right from his birth. As he has been growing up, he has been noticing the behavior of his grandmother. Generally, the little children would have talked to their grandparents and grandmother generally they recite some stories, and so they lull the little children, and the little children sleep at that moment. Sometimes they narrate the incidents of their life, of their childhood. As far as Khushwant Singh is concerned, he was not believing in the story of his grandmother that when she was a little child. It was a very surprising fact for him whether my grandmother was a little child any a day. That was unbelievable to him. So as the others were saying that she was very pretty, she was very beautiful. Actually, he has experienced that she was pretty, because whatever she was doing very nicely. She was behaving very nicely. Therefore, in that way, it is said that she was very pretty. She was very much anxious in the beginning of the time when Khushwant Singh's father and mother have gone to settle themselves in the city. At that time, Khushwant Singh was living along with his grandmother into the village. During that time, his grandmother was a very religious lady. Therefore, she was attending the religious place. As they were belonged to Sikha dynasty, therefore, no doubt at all, she was attending the religious place and she was reading the holy scripture. That is, the scripture belongs to them. And there was a primary school situated and located or adjusted with the same religious place. That is the temple. He was also reading the books as the priest was. They were just returning from the temple. The village dog were following them. As the lady was very religious, she was just keeping the steel chapati for the village dog. And they were eating and growling. They were enjoying the chapatis. And then after, by and by, this was very close connection found between grandmother and the child. Before going to the school, she was just preparing him, giving him bath, giving him breakfast, and preparing his slate, bag, and just hand over to Khushwant Singh. Actually, she does it in order to show the responsibility that the child should become a responsible person. And no doubt at all, he became. With the passage of time, his parents have summoned them, and Khushwant Singh along with his grandmother went to the city. In the city, he was admitted in English medium school. And he was just narrating what is going on into the school with his grandmother. His grandmother was very upset because everything was taught in English, not in Hindi, not in other language. And she was very upset because no religious teaching given to her grandchild. Once he was just narrating about the music class, she became much upset about it, that actually music belongs to the harlot and the dancers. They are of very low caste. She was against of it. And also, as Khushwant Singh was grown up, he was admitted in university. They were given a separate room. And also in this time, his grandmother was upset, but she was secluded, she was living solitary, she was hobbling the house, she was not interfering in any other's work. But she has just kept the idea that why she should be alone. She was just spinning the wheels, she was feeding the sparrows, she was reciting the prayer. All the time she was busy in her own work. And a day came when it was announced that Khushwant Singh will go abroad for further study in foreign. Now she thought that it is a wrong decision taken by Khushwant's father and mother. But she has gone to the station to see him off. At that time, Khushwant Singh felt the moist imprint over his forehead and he thought that it is the last physical contact between him and his grandmother. But after 5 years returning, when Khushwant returned after 5 years, he also saw his grandmother in the same condition, in the same age, and the same way as she was reciting the prayer. She was not a bit talking to anybody else. She has embraced her grandchild. And then she came to his house, her house. Now she collected the women of neighborhood, collected a dilapidated drum. But she started singing a warrior coming home. This time she was very much happy because barrier, now the, you can say, the warrior or the winner, the violent person, have come back. He has not settled himself there. And it was approximately the ending of grandmother. As she fell ill because of the overstraining of the drum, they arranged a doctor. Doctor said that it is a mild fever. Now her thought was something different from the thought of doctor. As the doctor said that it is a light fever and will go very soon. But she has, after the departure of the doctor, she said to the family member that it is the last occasion of her, it is the last time of her life. And she had not prayed for a long time because of the arrival of her grandchild. She thought differently and therefore she lay peacefully on the cot, started her prayer. Within a very short time, her finger became lifeless, the rosary fell out from her hand, and according to the customary, they took her out of the room, kept in the corridor, veranda, and they saw the blaze of light, sunlight. Now, after her death, they have just kept out from the room to the corridor and veranda. The blaze of light found welcoming, as the sun has been welcoming the dead body, as the dead body was covered with a red shroud. Now thousands of birds came over and silently sitting over the roof, over the corridor. They were not chirping to anybody. They were not chirping, they were not twittering, they were not giving any other movement. And after that, as they have took the dead body for the cremation, for the funeral, they the birds flew away. But before flying the birds, as the birds were seated silently there, Khushwant Singh's mother now threw the crumbs of bread, the pieces of bread, but the birds took no notice of it and they flew. Next morning, the sweeper has swept the crumbs and kept in the dustbin. Now here, as the story, it was the summary, and right now I am going to tell you the clear cut chapter. I come to the chapter. This chapter gives a picture of human relationship. That should be noted. Human relationship. It gives the picture of It gives the picture of human relationship in a joint family. Now, it is a factual description. The chapter is a factual description. Factual description, you know, that is factual, based on the real happening and the process. What happens actually, that is given in a proper chain, that is systematic and logical or true, known as factual description. So the chapter is a factual description and a realistic account. That is, the factual description is a realistic account. How the grandparents give all the attention and love to the family, to the grandchild. Now here, my grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. My grandmother, the author has used the word first person pronoun, personal pronoun, that is my. My is used for the writer. The writer has been writing about himself. My grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, that is generally, as she was looking, was an old woman. The old woman can become the grandmother or grandfather if the male is. So, she had been old and wrinkled for the 20 years that I had known her. From the childhood, the author has been observing his grandmother, and right now he has become 20 years old. From beginning to the 20 years, he has been daily observing his grandmother, and what does he notice? He had been old and she had been old and wrinkled for the 20 years. Wrinkled, there are many folds or contraction over the skins, that if you see the old person, then you will find the crisscross of the skins running the lines from here and there. That is a kind of fold, jhurri. Now, people said that she had once been young and pretty. He has been informed, Khushwant Singh has been informed that once she was very pretty. She was looking very attractive, pretty, that is attractive, a pleasant to look at, pleasant to look at, and had even had a husband, and actually she had a husband. But that was hard to believe. Here Khushwant Singh, it becomes impossible to Khushwant Singh when he was a little child. It was unbelievable to him. He could not believe over the other people's, other person's statement that once she was young and pretty. once she was young and pretty, this thing was unbelievable to him. He could not believe on the statement of others that ek samay mein ye badi achhi thi, badi khoobsurat thi, sundar thi. It was odd to Khushwant Singh. Unbelievable. He was not believing. It was hard to believe. My grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece. Mantelpiece just above the wall. Some projected points has been taken out and over that the portrait or the photographs have been kept. That is the mantelpiece. In the drawing room where they have decorated the drawing room by keeping the portrait of his grandmother, grandfather at the mantelpiece. He, Khushwant's grandfather, he wore a big turban. Wore. Big turban. Turban, that is the large piece of cloth as the people used to keep over their head. Turban. Mostly, if you go to Punjab, if you see the Sikhs, they used to wear turban. And loose fitting clothes. That is the loose garment. Loose cloth. He was wearing the loose cloth. Loose fitting cloth. The cloth was not fitting. It was fitting loose. Dhila dhala. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest and he looked at least 100 years old. How old was he looking? 100 years. In the portrait. In the portrait, he was looking 100 years. How? That he has a large beard. He has a large beard and his beard was at least has covered the half portion of his chest. It means up to this length, he has a beard. He has turban. His cloth was loose. Now, white beard. That is grey, that denotes old stage. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest and looked at least 100 years old. He did not look the short of person. He was not looking such a kind of person who would have a wife or children. Then what kind of person was he looking? He was not looking such a kind of person that he had a wife and children. It means he was looking as 100 years old so that it is supposed that he would have hundreds of children at last. Now, he looked as if he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. He was not looking such a kind of person that he had a child and wife. But what kind of person was he looking? He was looking as if he had lots and lots of many more children's. Grandfather he is. He has lots of grandchildren. Grandchildren, you know, that is the son of son. As for my grandmother being young and pretty, now this idea, the thought was almost revolting. Revolt, that actually a fight is going in the mind of the author. That he was just struggling to think about this condition of his grandmother, that once she was young and pretty. How is it possible? That I hadn't seen any time that she was young and pretty. This idea was revolting, that the understanding of the child could not develop. The child could not become mature. After being mature, that anybody can understand that a man who has become old, has covered the old stage, might have passed the same process. First he has become child and then grew and now has become old. But before maturity, the humble child cannot think such a point that once she was young and pretty. That was looking something different to him. She often told us, she was just telling, grandmother was telling us, the games she used to play as a child. Also, she was sharing, she was telling that when she was a little child, which game she was playing with her companion. The game she was playing with her companion in her childhood, this experience she has been sharing to her children, to her grandchild. That seemed quite absurd, odd. Absurd, that is odd. Odd number, you know. Odd. And undignified, not real. It seems unreal on her part, and we treated it like the fables, like the stories. Fables, that is the stories of the prophets she used to tell us. As we would have studied Aladdin ka Chirag, such a story, so it is not a real, only we listen it in the stories. So Khushwant Singh, in his childhood, it seems that the stories my grandmother is narrating is not real one, it is unreal story, it seems to him, as the story of Prophet Muhammad. Now, she had always been short. Here the author is going to narrate about the real quality of his grandmother. As she had always been short and fat, she was not very tall, she was fat or slightly bent. The posture of the body is not straight, she was little bit bent up. Now, as you see, someone, those are old, cannot move straight. They move just by a slight bending, or they have some sticks to totter over. Now, she had always been short and fat and slightly bent. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. There was no certain direction of the wrinkles and folds over her face. So many lines, foldings would have been formed. No, we were certain she had always been, as we had known her. Yes, according to our knowledge, she was the same as we were knowing her. Old. She was very old. Terribly. So terribly old. She was very, very old. Terribly old. Extremely she was old. None can go beyond that stage of oldness. Usse jyada koi budha nahi ho sakta hai. That is terribly old. That she could not have grown older. Yes, of course, she could not grown older than the stage of she is, and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. As far as the knowledge of the author, he has been observing his grandmother for 20 years. Now, he has been noticing that one cannot grow older than this stage as his grandmother was. But scientifically, she was just getting older and oldest condition. But as far as the narration is concerned, as far the explanation is concerned, the author has been saying generally that no one can grow older than such a stage of my grandmother. Now here, she could never have been pretty in his condition. As far as she was not looking much attractive to the author, because he has not seen her youth, young and childhood. But she was always beautiful in her deeds. She was always beautiful in her deeds, in her works. She hovered about the house in spotless white, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop, and the other tailing the breadth of her rosary. As if you have seen the hermit's sage saint priest at the temple, they would be noticed that they have a rosary into their hands and have been reciting the name of God or Goddess. That is known as rosary. The beds of as the pieces of tulsi, rudraksha, and many more things. These are known as rosary. If number of pieces has been just pierced together or fastened in a thread, made a circle, that is known as rosary. The religious personalities now just recite the name of God over the rosary. Now, how was she looking? She could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. She hobbled about the house. She was just moving or going here and there into the house. Hobbled. Hobbling. As moving, not straight, by bending. Hobbled about the house in spotless white. She was wearing white sari. She was having a white complexion. She has the white hair. Lock of hair was white. Everything was white. So she was spotless. There was no spot, no other spot except the whiteness of her body. With one hand resting on her waist, one hand she has been keeping on her waist in order to make her balance, that she should not fall, as she was not leaving a club or a stick. She hadn't any club or a stick, koi lathi danda nahi tha, but she has been keeping her hands over her waist that it should give support to her. And in the other hand, in the right hand, she was just keeping the rosary and reciting the name of God. But she was not announcing. She was not making sound. Only her lips were running. It seems that she has been speaking something else. She has not been uttering. As I have been giving the voice, she was not giving. She was just uttering it, but the movement of the lips can be seen. Could you understand? Now here, resting on her waist to balance her stoop, to balance her bending, and the other tailing the beads of her rosary. Her silver lock, lock of hair, as it is white in color, silver locks were scattered and tidy, scattered here and there. Just uncombed, you can say, or few parts of the hair were just running down or scattered here and there. Silver lock were scattered untidy over her place, her pale puckered face. Pale puckered, pale because she was having a fair complexion. Complexion, that is the color of the living being. Complexion is known for the color of living being. जीवित प्राणियों के लिए रंग का अगर हम बात करते हैं तो कलर शब्द का यूज नहीं करते हैं, हम कॉम्प्लेक्शन शब्द का यूज करते हैं. कॉम्प्लेक्शन का मतलब होता है उसका रूप, रंग, रंग से मतलब होता है. नाउ पेल येलोइस पुकर्ड फेस एज देयर इज नो प्रॉपर टूथ इन द माउथ. Therefore, puckered face, as because of the wrinkles and the face is puckered. And her lips constantly moved in, as I told you, that she was reciting prayer. Her lips were constantly, continuously moving. Inaudible prayer that cannot be heard. Inaudible prayer, a prayer. Moved in, inaudible prayer. Audible and inaudible. Audible that can be heard, inaudible that cannot be heard. Audible opposite inaudible. Yes, she was beautiful. Of course, the writer has been giving stress that she was beautiful. She was like the winter landscape. winter landscape. Right now, if you have been meeting with news in these days, the Baltistan or Gilgit or some mountain areas as the valley that have become the spot of quarrel with China. Now you would have seen the mountain area, that the snow-capped mountain was looking white in color, just as that is known as landscape. Landscape. She was looking white in color from head to foot, as she was having the white hair, she was having fair complexion, she was wearing white sari, and she was spotless. Why? Because she was a very religious lady, therefore she was holy, and so it can be known as beautiful and white. Therefore the writer has compared his grandmother with the white landscape. Now she was like the winter landscape in mountain, an expanse of pure white serenity. Serenity, that is a holiness. Quiet, silent, still, calm. She was looking so silent, so still, so calm, so quiet. And now, breathing peace and contentment. Contentment, she was satisfied. She was not interfering in the affair of house. She was doing her own work herself. She was not bothering any member of the family. What she has been given, what she was doing, she was satisfied to herself. Contentment. She was fully satisfied. And she was keeping peace. Still, quiet, silent. She was not quarreling. Even she was not thinking about quarreling. Now, my grandmother and I were a good friend. Now the author has been going to describe about the beginning stage of his life. There are three stages of life described here in the chapter. My grandmother and I were good friends. My grandmother and I. Now, grandmother, third person, I, first person. Okay. And the verb, agreement of the verb used as were, because we have to follow antecedent. My parents left me with her when they went to live in the city, and we were constantly together. We were living continuously, constantly. We were living continuously into the village. Who were living continuously into the village? Grandmother and Khushwant Singh are the grandchild. Whereas Khushwant's parents have gone to city to settle their life. She used to wake me up. Used to. That is the habitual action of the past. Habitual action of the past, used to, uthaya karna, prayog kiye karna. She used to wake me up in the morning, subah wo jagaya karti thi, and get me ready, casuative, get me ready. This phrase is used as casuative. वो मुझे जगाया करती थी, उठाया करती थी, प्रयोग किया करती थी. यूज्ड टू एंड गेट एंड मेड, दीज थ्री थिंग्स. रेडी फॉर स्कूल, सी गेट मी रेडी, वो मुझे तैयार करती थी. सी सेड हर मॉर्निंग प्रेयर इन ए मोनोटोनस सिंग सॉन्ग. मोनोटोनस, दैट इज इन अ सेम रिदमिक टोन. In a single rhythmic tone, the rhythm of the song does not change. In a one tune, she was singing the morning prayer. While she was giving him bath and doing other things. Prayer in a monotonous sing song. While she bathed and dressed me in the hope that I would listen and get to know it by heart. There may be a question. यहाँ एक प्रश्न बन सकता है कि वो monotonous sing song में क्यों गाती थी? The answer is here. तो answer भी है. That she bathed and dressed me in the hope. In the hope. She sings a monotonous song in the hope that I would listen and learn it by heart. सुन सुन के मैं याद कर लूँगा और उस प्रेयर को बोलता रहूँगा. In such a hope, she was singing monotonous song. Now, I listened. Yes. I was not bothered to learn. Only I was listening that my grandmother is singing because I loved her voice, but never bothered to learn it. I never took any pressure, any difficulty to learn. I never tormented myself to learn it. Then she would fetch my wooden slate, bring wooden slate, that is the writing pad made of wood that was used or that was a means of writing in the olden days, olden time, or you can say 30 or 40 years before. It was used. Then she would fetch my wooden slate, which she had already washed and plastered with yellow chalk. She apply yellow chalk over the wooden slate in order to that the writing over the plastered wooden slate would become nice. See, as we erase the board, sometimes if it is made of concrete, we apply polish so that the writing should be seen neat and clean. In that condition, tiny earthen ink pot, the ink pot that was made of earth, made of soil, not made of bottle type. Now, earthen ink pot and red pen, that is the pen made of red, that is a kind of wild grass. Red is a kind of wild grass, narkat, ya kuch is tarah ki cheezon se banaya hua kalam, pen. Tie them all in a bundle, wooden slate, earthen chalk and pen, tie them all in a bundle and hand it to me. Hand over. That is a kind of responsibility allotted to the child. Hand over. And after a breakfast of a thick stale chapati, they use breakfast before going to the temple or the school. They took their breakfast, and what was the material of the breakfast? Stale chapati, not fresh chapati, that is the stale chapati. Stale chapati is, that is the dish that has been prepared at the night, previous night. Now, with a little butter, apply over the butter, sugar is spread on it. Butter, sugar that has been applied over the chapati, that is the breakfast. We went to school. and we went to school. She carried several steel chapatis with her for the village dogs. Now, as for your some understanding questions, better you to write down the questions that can give you the clear idea about the TAT portion. Now, whose portrait was hung over the mantelpiece? Whose portrait was hung over the mantelpiece? Okay? Now, how was his grandfather looked? What was revolting okay. Now you are supposed to answer these questions, and in our next class, the remaining portions will be continued. Thank you, dears.